Good morning, respected judges and delegates. I am here to present the spectrum of HIV ophthalmopathy among the patients of antiretroviral therapy and its correlation with CD4 T cell count. Studies have demonstrated that 40 to 45% of HIV infected patients have some form of ophthalmic manifestations, but previous prevalence studies generally done within populations who are selected on the basis of symptoms or ophthalmological referral. But the aim of my study is to conduct an epidemiological survey to analyze the prevalence and HIV related eye involvement in all newly diagnosed HIV patients prior to the start of antiretroviral therapy. This is a cross-sectional study which is done among 271 newly diagnosed HIV infected patients over 1 year. The diagnosis of ocular HIV was based on suggestive ocular lesion with systemic infection and data interpreted accordingly. And we have seen that 33.6% patients have some form of ophthalmic involvement and majority of them are male. 17.4% patients have both eye involved and 14.3% of them have low vision. Most commonly involved structure was posterior segment, and we have found that even with ophthalmic involvement, most of them were completely asymptomatic. And we have also found that patients with comorbidity, like some form of hemophilia or thalassemia, they have more chances of ophthalmic involvement in HIV. This is the final summary of involved structure. And we have seen that neuro-ophthalmological manifestation is least common in HIV patients. And we have also seen that with increased stages of HIV, chances of ophthalmic involvement is more. And it is also seen more commonly with decreased CD4 count. These are pictures of ophthalmic involvement in HIV patients. And the frequency of ocular manifestation is 33.6% in our study, which is also corroborative in study conducted in Ethiopia. And study conducted by Pathais et al. Also found that 80% patient of HIV infected patients, they have normal vision, which is corroborative with our study. Our study is also corroborative with study done by Listo Bien et al., who also showed that posterior segment involvement is more in case of HIV. In our study, we found that 46.2% patients were completely asymptomatic, even they have ophthalmic involvement. This is also noted in a study done by Pathais et al. Also, he has shown that prevalence of ophthalmic lesion associated with HIV is higher in patients with WHO clinical stage 3 or 4. And this is corroborative with our study also done by Jabs et al. Now we can conclude that the severity of ocular infection in HIV or AIDS in the form of visual impairment was higher in patients with low CD4 count and advanced stages of HIV. So when a HIV infected patients come to our antiretroviral therapy clinic, a multidisciplinary approach along with proper ophthalmological evaluation is a must. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Pallavi. I have a question. Did you take any comorbidities into account? Suppose a patient who had HIV and had diabetes had a higher incidence of the disease that you have shown?
Yes, I have taken the patients with comorbidity, and I have seen that if they have more chances of ophthalmic involvement, but any other kind of immunodeficiency disorder, if they have, other than HIV, we have excluded that patient.
A quick question by Dr. Nanda, sir. Sir, you are muted, sir.
Okay. Any result you have?
Yes, sir.
Marathi, sir, you can ask.
No. Sir, you continue after your question.
No, you ask it. No problem.
Oh, it is not my question. Sir, please.
You just go on here.
Okay, yeah. Okay. Dr. Pallavi, have you observed that number of cases over the years? What's your observation? Is going down or going up?
Sir, it is going up, definitely. And I have also seen that it is more common in urban population.
Okay. And
the reporting by the male is more. I think in our antiretroviral therapy is more what I have learned
that recently means over the years I think the number is not that way increasing in means in case of HIV.
Okay, next question by Nanda sir.
Unmute yourself.
Thank you, Pallavi. No problem.
Yes, thank you, sir.
Next, Dr. Srini.
Dr. Pallavi.
Yes.
What point are these people coming for an ophthalmic evaluation, and at what point are the treating physicians actually sending the patients for ophthalmic evaluation, and is there a trend in earlier referral for ophthalmic evaluation?
Sir, actually, I have taken all the patients who came for antiretroviral therapy irrespective of their referral, because previous studies have done only if there is symptom present or if there is ophthalmological referral. But my study is irrespective of referral. I have taken all the new patients who are starting to their antiretroviral therapy.
Okay.